y'all. I made it to Cali, it to Long Beach, California. Just waiting on my bags and then off to my hotel. So after I checked into my hotel, I headed to this place called Crimson Cowboy Chicken. It was Nashville hot chicken. It's actually pretty good. This is the inside of it. It's pretty empty because I went pretty late, but I ordered this number right here. Some kind of chicken fries. Came with coleslaw on top, some type of sauce, pickles, Nashville hot chicken tenders that were cut up. It was actually pretty good. I added the coleslaw in. Overall, I rated a 3 out of 5 spoons. Check it out if you're ever in Cali. Alright y'all, so I'm on a Carnival cruise. I'm trying Guy's Burgers. I'm finna get into it. Alright y'all, this is my burger right here. It's called the Bourbon. Got, I added bacon because y'all know I'm difficult. But it's got onion rings, slaw, pickles, tomato, all that. I wish y'all could, I can't see it. Okay, I'm about to try it. We're gonna see what the hype is about. Let's see what Guy Fieri is all about. Off the rip. This is a juicy burger. Seasoned pretty good. Onion rings are crispy. Okay, Guy. I see you. That's what it's all about. That macaroni was made by Tony. Ooh, that macaroni is so good. Tony made that macaroni. Macaroni. Alright, y'all. So, we still in Long Beach. Still in the port of Long Beach. Carnival cruise behind me with all the beautiful things going on. Let me show y'all before we pull off though. That is the famous Queen Mary haunted cruise or haunted ship. No, I ain't go on. No, I will not go on. I rebuke those spirits in the name of Jesus. But that is the famous Queen Mary. This is the sweet life. Y'all, I still ain't found Mr. Mosby. I ain't found London Tipton. I ain't found Zach or Cody. Damn. So here's a quick room tour. Got the king size bed right there. TV on the wall, as well as mirror, vanity area, some closet space. That was bathroom. I almost tripped going in there. Watch your step. All right, y'all. So I'm sure y'all can't hear me. Tomorrow I will do a full food review. All the food served from breakfast all the way to dinner. I might do one tonight for dinner. Dinner is in about another hour or so. We haven't pulled off from Long Beach as of yet. We should be pulling off pretty soon though from Long Beach. Tonight there's going to be a comedy show that I'm going to go to. They also have movies out on the deck. There's a wine tasting or something like that that I'm going to partake in. And then there's a singles mixer. There's a club night. Right now they're doing the 50th year celebration for Carnival. So pretty much just throwing a party on deck. But yeah, I can't wait to take you guys along with me on the journey. Thank y'all for riding with me so far. But yeah, y'all know how your boy do. I'm getting ready to enjoy myself. It's vacation time, okay? Y'all have a blessed one. Love y'all. And before I go, let me give y'all the fit check. Hat by Jay's Jewels, you already know what it is. Glasses mine, chain mine. All right, then we got a shirt by the Stevens. It says manifesting the things that God has for me. Y'all know what it is. Watch on deck, you got the suede with the gold. Y'all know what it is, the shoes, got the boots. I'm looking fresh, looking fly, I'm feeling good. Y'all, I'm having an amazing time. I just thank God for everything he's done for me.
Now put them hands on them hips. Let that backbone We got Cat in the Hat, Big One and Big Two here too. And I need you to sing it out loud and proud. Na 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 na.
Oh!
So this is night one in the captain's dining hall. Beautiful view overlooking the ocean as well, the upstairs floor. I got a nice little quaint table. These are some of the menu items. They're the appetizers, the main entrees. They even had desserts as well as cocktails that you can order from a pretty extensive and long menu. They also had some upgraded selections as well that you could purchase. And of course, everything else was complimentary. Pretty, like I said, extensive menu. It's really actually quite nice. They start you off with some bread and butter, as well as some olive oil and balsamic vinaigrette, if that's what you would like. And then I got the corn chowder. This is the shrimp cocktail. That's the grilled salmon. Here is the flame broiled New York strip steak. Dessert was the malted lava cake. And I also got a strawberry coulis. It was quite delicious. Got out of the hot tub, took a little bit of a relaxing break, but I just wanted to update you guys, give you a little bit of information, or kind of tell you guys about my experience so far. It's been a pretty decent experience so far. So last night I went to the dinner. You're allowed like two entrees per person, or two of everything, two entrees, two appetizers, two sides, whatever. So I was like, hell yeah, why not? So I got the for the appetizer, I got the shrimp cocktail and the poblano, corn poblano soup. It's really, really good. Shrimp cocktail with a corn poblano chowder was excellent. Definitely 10 out of 10, would recommend and would get it again. Now, about the entree. So I got the flame broiled New York strip and the salmon. Both were served with buttered potatoes and roasted veggies. Needed a little work, not gonna lie to y'all. The salmon was decent, but it was very dry. Some butter or just some kind of olive oil drizzle on top would have nailed the coffin for me. And so I did request it. I added butter to it, and then it eventually just got a whole world better. The steak with the peppercorn sauce and the roasted veggies, pretty decent. Overall, just needed some seasoning. So added some salt to it. It was much better. Then for the dessert, I had a strawberry coulis, which was like a mousse, strawberry style mousse, with some fresh strawberries and like a wafer cake. That was actually really good. It was really delightful. It almost tasted like a vanilla wafer. It was really good. Or a strawberry wafer. The malted chocolate cake, however, was really, I don't know if it was underdone or if that's just how they do it. It had like the thinnest layer of cooked cake on top, and it was just all chocolate, ooey gooey, too muchness underneath. And yeah, that kind of did it for me. So overall, let me see. So the corn chowder, I would rate 3.5 out of 5 spoons. Really, really good. Really good. The shrimp cocktail, 2.5 out of 5 spoons. It was shrimp cocktails. Not a whole lot going on to it. The salmon, had there been some butter, it probably would have been a 4. But since there was like nothing just to seal in and some extra moisture, it's a little dry. I have to give it a 2.5 out of 5 spoons. Yeah, that's just the way the cookie crumbles. For the flame broiled steak. Now the steak was cooked perfectly. The peppercorn sauce was really, really good, and it was much needed because if I didn't have that, then buttered potatoes didn't have no butter on them. They didn't have no salt on them. They didn't have no nut. It was just some nubs of potatoes. So that really brought the dish together. And then, like I say, it just needed salt. So I just give that a 3 out of 5 spoons. You know, that was pretty decent. And yeah, that's it so far. Oh yeah, so the dessert. So the strawberry coulis, I give that a 4 out of 5 spoons. So delicious, so light, so refreshing. It was really good. The malted lava cake or whatever, I give a 1 out of 5 spoons. It's too much. Too much chocolate, and it just wasn't good. Served with a side of ice cream, but it wasn't good. Okay. Also, on last night, you'll see some video clips of it. But yeah, they had like a nightclub as well, mixers, and all kind of stuff going on. It was really interesting, really cool time. Had fun dancing, and music was somewhat popping. The DJ just kept shuffling in the most random songs that made everybody leave the dance floor. And then a good DJ knows how to cut and mix songs together so that they can, if they lose a crowd for a hot second, they know how to put songs rhythmically together, splice them together, cut them together so that they can bring another hit back in to bring people back in on the dance floor. Unfortunately, it was like he cut to a song, it was bad. Everybody gets off the dance floor, and instead of putting in some type of hit or dance beat or something to make people get back on the dance floor, he just kept playing the same style of music. And eventually it was like just a mix. First, it was just a really good mix. First, it started off 90s throwbacks, and then it went into kind of some today's and salt and pepper, you know, some stuff in. And then it went to island, like, Jamaican style dance music, and that between that and Spanish music, we're just going back and forth between those two. And you know, every now and again you get a Spanish song or some type of Afro beat that, you know, hit, but then for the most part it was just like dead after that, so I left. But overall it was a pretty good experience. So this is my view. Mexico, also Baja California. I wanted to get off the boat, and I did for like hot 20 minutes and got right back on. I thought that there was going to be some beach territory, and I am told that there is, but it's pretty far off, and you have to, you know, get a cab or something like that out there. Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. I'm tired. I didn't go to sleep till like 3 o'clock tomorrow. But, and I'm on Pacific time, California time. So that was really like 5 o'clock in the morning, my central time. But anyway, so I got out of the boat for like 20 minutes, walked maybe up to the pier, and then said, forget it. I'm going to turn around. Because, I mean, honestly, it was just. Unless you like to shop and walk around doing nothing, this is the perfect place for you. It's not as beachy. It's very mountainous. Beautiful homes. Right here to my right, I'll show y'all in just a second. Beautiful homes, beautiful scenery, but, you know, not a lot to do. And then the excursions, you had to, like, get your transportation to the excursions, and it's a bit much. So my mental capacity, I'm here to like relax. My mental capacity was not on figuring all of that out. So I chose to stay on the boat. I'm gonna hit the water on the boat. May get off again just to go get a drink or something. Just to say I had tequila in Mexico. But other than that, I'm A-okay. Your boy Daviana and still on my Carnival cruise, so I decided to try out the shack, the big chicken here on the boat. So the shack does have like an actual chicken restaurant, chicken sandwich restaurant, tenders and other stuff. So he has a partnership with Carnival Cruise Line. So this is the big chicken. It comes with sides. You can either get jalapeno slaw, they have potato salad, and they have these sweet and spicy pickles. So I did the sweet and spicy pickles. I also did the potato salad. This one is called the Uncle Jerome. I'm gonna try some of the other ones like later on throughout the day or whatever. About the rest of the cruise and just give y'all a full review. But this is the one decided to try now. It's called the Uncle Jerome. It has a Nashville hot fried chicken. It actually only comes with lettuce and lettuce and pickle. I opted in for the coleslaw, the jalapeno slaw. So I changed it up for me. I customized it. And it comes with some type of sauce. And it's not the shack sauce. It comes with some like wedge fries. I don't know if you can see them. So we're about to see what it do. All right, y'all, so off the rip, this looks pretty messy, so I'm gonna go ahead and like lay this down. I already know, y'all know me, I would get any and everything on myself, so I'm just gonna lay this down real quick. Okay, and I don't even know where to attack it. There's a crap ton of pickles on here, crap ton of slaw on here, so I'm just gonna pick it up and try to get it in. This was a fresh fried chicken patty as well, so I'm with it all day long. See that drippage already? Here we go. Let's get it. Mm. Okay. Let me get one more bite. No, it's not like that. Green chicken sauce. Off the rip. Cheese, the chicken. It's pretty juicy. It's fresh. On the sign it says you have the option for white meat or dark meat chicken, so breast or thigh. They didn't ask. I got a chicken breast. It's pretty juicy. You can definitely tell it's brine chicken. Lots of pepper throughout the breast patty. Other than that, it's not very seasoned or flavored. The patty itself, the slaw, it's jalapeno slaw. I don't taste any jalapeno. It just tastes like cabbage and maybe a little bit of brine. Pickles are good, but overall, the sandwich, kind of underwhelming. I give it a 2.5 out of 5, okay? It's just me. Now to move on to the potato salad. I don't know what this potato salad is. Not potato salad that I've seen before. We're finna try it. Conflicted. That's the word I would describe. It's very conflicted. It's creamy, needs salt. I'm guessing the dressing is like a combination of pickles, sack sauce, and ranch. It's very odd flavor. Needs some salt, maybe needs a touch of sugar. It might be working some. But right now, it's a 1.5 out of 5 for me, Shaq. This ain't your mama's recipe. I know it. If it is, I'm not eating a potato salad. All right, so these are the pickles, the sweet and spicy pickles. And they look like just brine cucumbers, which is what pickles is anyway, but this seems like a regular old brine cucumber. Let's give it a taste. Sorry. Like a whole peppercorn in my mouth. That actually has some potential. In order for it to be sweet and spicy, though, I need to taste the sweetness as equally aggressively as I taste the spice. And I'm not getting that. Maybe it was a bad batch. Almost reminds me of kimchi pickles. Very good. There's a touch more sweetness. That's all it needs. Give it a 3.5 out of 5. All right, y'all. So last but not least, I have the Shaq sauce. You can see it right back here. It's the Shaq sauce. I didn't want to try any of the other ones. I know what barbecue sauce tastes like. Barbecue ranch, I can imagine my taste buds mixing barbecue sauce and ranch. He had a couple of different sauces that just didn't seem necessary for me to try. So I'm going to try the Shaq sauce. I got the thin wedged fries. Very weird. Thin wedged fries. Very oxymoronic, but I'm gonna try. Got a little crispy texture to them. Feels real crispy like, but they're also very flappy and flaky like you can see. Yeah, Shaq sauce, let's go. Honestly, tastes like a very aggressive attempt at Chick-fil-A sauce. That's what it tastes like. A very aggressive attempt. And I say attempt very heavily. A very aggressive attempt at Chick-fil-A sauce. It's good. But it's like when you find out what the ingredients to Chick-fil-A sauce is, and you try to make it yourself, and then you add too much of a specific ingredient. Barbecue sauce. It's like very barbecue sauce forward in an array of Chick-fil-A sauce ingredients. I give it a 3 out of 5. It's good, but very aggressive attempt. It's decent. It's good. So yeah, that's my Shaq food review. I may try some of the other sandwiches, along my journey here. I'll also do a couple more food reviews on like everything that they have here. Just haven't been able to try everything yet. But I will. All right. So I love y'all. Y'all stay blessed. So on this particular night, I decided to go see the in-house comedian. He was actually pretty funny. Not that great, but funny. These are some of the menu items for tonight. They're a little bit different than last night's menu items. So I decided to try a couple of different things. But as you can see, the menu is still pretty long and extensive. Lots of options to choose from. A little bit of something for everybody. So I thought that was great. I ended up starting off with the pork medallions. They were actually really, really good. They had some type of cheese filling and then like a pineapple chimichurri glaze thing. It was good. The Italian wedding soup, which came with like meatballs and vegetables. Pretty interesting. I got the prime rib, of course. I wanted to see what that's all about. Everything else needed a little help. Then I got the Chilean sea bass with potato gnocchi and peas. So they started the next morning off with a Cat in the Hat themed brunch for families. I didn't have any kids, but I thought this was a great experience. If I had been a kid or had a kid, that definitely would have been something that was on the agenda. I just went down, kind of poked around. Look at the table setting. It's so nice. Everything is so well decorated. Of course, they had the green eggs and ham and lots of other menu options. But I thought it was just a cool little fun thing for the kids to do. Very thoughtful and considerate. So, yeah, that was a pretty awesome experience. You in the middle! Make a Man Out of You is probably one of the dopest songs. I like it. You know, it doesn't matter. That's
like
shit.
Lion King 1 and Lion King 2. I don't like the one with Beyonce that they
redid. Oh, yeah. I hate Beyonce's voice.
You said you hate her voice?
I hate her voice. Her talking voice.
She sings.
Well.
She sings. I have to like...
Y'all, so I made it off of the boat okay. It's been a very interesting experience. Some of my experiences I'm gonna have to tell you guys about in post once I make it back to Texas. But yeah, it's been a very interesting experience overall. From my first cruise, of course, there's always gonna be ups, downs, hiccups, hangups, unexpecteds when you're doing any kind of traveling. But with that being said, considering all the things that I experienced on this very first cruise, I would rate it a 6.5 out of 10. Again, that's just with what I experienced this first go round. Of course, I plan to do another one, maybe a different cruise line or maybe just a different destination pretty soon. But like I say, I'll tell you guys a little bit more about my experiences post. Hope you guys have enjoyed the video so far. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. And yeah, this is a pretty big review. I've done plenty of food reviews, but it's an entire food review on a cruise line. So hope y'all enjoy it. Y'all have a blessed one. Remember to go and always be great because you already are. Love y'all.